recognition and just sort of what he's meant to you guys this year?
Well, it's certainly well deserved. I think anyone that's watched our team play, I've said this all season long, is not only is he a first team All-SEC performer, but he's been the most valuable player to any one team in our league. And it's nice that he's recognized both being All-League and being on the All-Defensive team. The biggest thing about Josh to me is how he's grown as a leader from a guy early when we took the program over by doing it by example, or, you know, just leading the way without saying much. And then as we got into the fall and an early part of our season, he's become a vocal leader. He encourages the young guys. He challenges his teammates if they're not working as hard as he thinks they should be. So he's been fantastic. Only problem with Josh is that he's a senior. I wish he was a sophomore or junior, but he's a special young guy.
Coach, he's looking to be the first Tennessee player to make the All-Defensive team twice in this league. He said he wanted to leave as one of the best defenders in Tennessee history. Do you think he's kind of secured that place with that award? How has he been able to keep his defense up despite playing a completely different scheme this season?
Well, we'll see how he guards against Vanderbilt, if he's considered one of the best when his career is over. But, you know, I think really the way we play probably has helped him as a defender, because he's been able to show people, talking about our league coaches and then afterwards with professional basketball, that he can guard in the full court. He came up with a ton of steals in our press. And then in our zone, it probably has helped keep him out of foul trouble some, where if you guard man-to-man, maybe they isolate him and try to drive him and do different things to pick up cheap fouls. So I think schematically, it's been good for Josh. He's proven his first 3 years he can guard in the half court. Now he's proven he can play passing lanes and guard in the full court.
Are there any surprises at this point against the team you've played twice?
You know, Coach Stallings is a great coach, so I can guarantee he will add a thing, whether it's an in-line, out-of-bounds play or a set play against our zone, to try to get a good look. You know, they tweaked a few things from game one to game two, and they even tweaked how they played from the first half to the second half in the second game. So I'm sure he'll make some adjustments. We certainly will make a few, and then the five guys on each side got to go out and get it to the floor.
How big is the three-point line in this matchup, given how well they can shoot and how well they shot it last time you saw
them? Well, they're shooting it about as well as any team in America. They went to Ole Miss and made 13 threes, and so it's obviously a huge key in this game. You got to get out and guard the three-point line. The problem is, as you stretch your defense, and now you've got a monster inside in Jones that you're trying to guard with, you know, Derek Reese at 6'7", or a freshman in Tariq and Willie that just aren't physical enough yet to guard him. So we're going to have to do a good job of doubling down and helping on the post, but then quickly getting out to shooters, and that's easier said than done.
Got a lot of guys that haven't played in a tournament at this level before. How do you kind of present this opportunity?
Well, you try to make it be like any other game. You know, you prepare the same way, and you just talk about the one thing that maybe is a little different is that you have to have sense of urgency. We preach it every game, every possession anyway, but now it really is do or die. If you lose, your season's over, and you would hope that these guys are still excited to play. We've had good practices, and I think they'll play with a sense of urgency without hopefully being too uptight or nervous that, you know, if you make a mistake, it can cost your team the game.
I know it's your first year, but do you think Bridgestone and Nashville is a good location to be the almost permanent home of the tournament?
I think it really is. I mean, I think obviously from our standpoint it would be great for our fans, but I think Nashville is a great city that the fans would like to come and hang out for a few days, enjoy the setting. And, you know, we've had pretty good success in there when we were at Moorhead, so hopefully we can carry that over the years here at Tennessee.
Did you play some OVC tournaments there?
Yeah, we did. I think three, if I'm not mistaken. Maybe it was two, but we won twice. I think both were there, but for sure one of the two.
Bridgestone or Municipal?
I think maybe one was at Municipal, one was at Bridgestone.
2011 was at Municipal, 2009.
Yeah.
So you've cut down the nets in Bridgestone?
We have, yeah.
This is kind of off the subject, but we have somebody working on a story, up three, closing seconds. What do you do, foul or not foul? What's your general philosophy on that?
Well, I think it's predicated on time and score, where the ball is being taken out of bounds from. You know, our deal is kind of 6 or 7 seconds or less. We probably foul over that. You're giving yourself a chance to be two possessions, a two for one on their end. So, again, time and score. the seconds on the clock and where it's being taken out from all comes into play.
You had that situation with Arkansas. I mean, did that kind of change your opinion at all?
Yeah, I mean, you know, the guy shoots from half court and they give him three shots. And so, you know, you're looking back on it and say, why did we do that? Of course, he missed, so it works out. But you just got to do a better job. I said then that was on me. We should have fouled earlier. We let him get too far up the court. And so if we do that, then I hope we're in that position. We'll have to make a tough call, but 6 seconds or less would be the deal we would probably foul.
What do you think it says about the league this year? That I think you said yesterday that's pretty much wide open, other than probably Kentucky, but the league is better as a whole this season. What does it say about the league that it's, I think it's a pretty puncher's chance, but also it's better across the board?
Well, you know, and I agree, two things. It makes the tournament very exciting for the fans. I think everyone in our league feels like you got a legitimate chance to at least make it to the final, and I think all the rest of the coaches would say now Kentucky's a little bit different deal. But you know, I know a few years ago Vanderbilt beat a really good Kentucky team in the final, and so things can happen on a neutral floor in tournament play. And I think our league overall, as you said, Ben, is really, really good from top to bottom, and probably still doesn't get the respect or notoriety we deserve. But it's a good basketball league and getting better.
The orange blazer staying in the closet?
Yeah, we're going to go normal suit this game. Well, the last time it didn't work, we're on a neutral floor, so we're going to go regular suit.
Thanks, guys.
All right.